Okay, get ready for something amazing. Yep, that's it. The fact that I could just turn on a faucet and clean, safe water comes out, it's pretty darn miraculous. In many parts of the world, I might have to walk half a day to get my water, and the water could look a lot more like this, or look alright but actually be filled with things that could make me really sick, like microbes and heavy metals. I'm gonna take a sip. But first, I'm gonna clean it. Even this water can be made drinkable with some pretty cool chemistry. And the story of how this becomes this actually begins in the laundry aisle. In the late 1990s, scientists were working on a way to take soap and gunk out of dirty laundry water so that it could be reused to rinse clothes. It wasn't for some new kind of high-end washing machine. It was for underdeveloped areas where women and girls were walking hours to get water to wash clothes, and then making the trip again for the clean water to rinse them. That didn't leave much time for things like going to school.
Around the world, women are the caregivers of the household. They are often the ones responsible for getting water for the day.
But as the scientists worked on the problem, they realized that their strategy could be used for something even more important: drinking water. 800 million people worldwide, about 1 in 10, don't have reliable access to clean and safe water. That includes 30 million people in the United States whose drinking water doesn't even pass EPA standards.
What's actually in that water making it dirty?
You'll often see the water is maybe brown. That can be wash off from soil. And then you'll also find quite a lot of particulate in the water, silts and clays. But the most serious ones are the microbiological contaminations that can make you very ill very quickly.
Remember, dirty water isn't just about the stuff you can see. It can carry all kinds of disease-causing microbes, including cholera, dysentery, hepatitis A, polio, and typhoid. These microbes usually come from cross-contamination with wastewater. And yes, I mean water that contains human and animal feces. Water is also often literally dirty, full of clay, silt, and sediment from erosion. Heavy metals like lead and arsenic can leach into even clean-looking wells. Ultimately, it's an infrastructure problem, but those fixes take time. So right now, it's about short-term solutions. One of those solutions is in this, a teabag-sized packet containing a potent chemical triple threat. It's a water treatment plant that works one bucket at a time. And today, I'm gonna try it out. This is 10 liters of water pulled right out of a river near my house. It may not look dirty, but on its website, the city says, at all times, avoid contact with the water, wash with soap if you do touch it, and definitely do not drink the water. Here's some of what I saw when I put it under the microscope. I dump the packet in, stir, and then chemistry takes over. It works in three stages: coagulate, flocculate, disinfect. So let's co-flocculate. Step one, coagulation. The first ingredient to work is ferric sulfate, which is basically a powdered form of iron. As soon as it hits the water, it breaks apart, releasing positively charged iron ions into the liquid. Everybody knows that when you mix iron and water, you get rust. Iron rusts because its ions react with water and the oxygen dissolved in it. That's in clean water. In unclean water, with lots of negatively charged dirt particles and heavy metals, the iron grabs onto those instead, clumping them together. To accelerate that coagulation, the packet also contains bentonite clay, the same stuff that makes face masks and kitty litter clump. The clay ensures that there's enough sediment for the coagulation to happen. It starts a snowball effect with the rest of the dirt. In other words, if the water isn't quite dirty enough, like the clear water that I started with, you add the clay to make it dirtier first. Next up, flocculation. The second main ingredient in the packet is polyacrylamide. It's a high molecular weight polymer that wraps around the coagulated dirt clumps. The timing is key. Polyacrylamide dissolves in the solution slowly, giving the coagulation time to happen first. Then the polyacrylamide chains bind the clumps together, forming even larger, heavier, stickier particles called flocs. Those heavy flocs fall to the bottom of the bucket, leaving clean water above. Now, some bacteria and viruses may get pulled down with the flocs. But to make the water truly safe to drink, you need to disinfect. That's where the third and final ingredient comes in. Chlorine in the form of powdered calcium hypochlorite. Added to water, it forms hypochlorous acid. Like most disinfectants, hypochlorous acid breaks apart the microbe's lipid membrane. In water, some of the hypochlorous acid also splits into hydrogen ions and hypochlorite, which disrupt and denature proteins throughout the cell. And after it kills the microbes in the bucket, residual chlorine keeps the water safe from reinfection during storage.
Having a little bit of chlorine in there can kill off any of the contamination that might come in from the environment, be that through the air or kids dipping their hands in as they scoop out water from a container.
And while it kills the bacteria, the chlorine in the water is well below the maximum amount recommended by the CDC. There's a low concentration of chlorine in the tap water that most of us in the US drink every day. Now that the microbes have been killed and the larger particles have separated out, you simply filter the water through cloth to remove any remaining particles. So far, this little packet has provided more than 18 billion liters of clean water. That's 7,200 Olympic swimming pools, one bucket at a time.
It keeps families healthy to go to school, to go to work, pursue the opportunities they want to.
It's not a permanent solution, but the difference is clear.
What is for you the most rewarding part?
Knowing that we're able to help so many people with the technology that can be life-changing.
There's nothing quite like the emotional connection you actually get when you meet people and they can tell you exactly how this has transformed life for them and their family.